Welcome guys to another episode of Samsung Developers. I'm Kim, and today we'll take on the native piano sample app on the Tizen IDE to cover the topic on Edge Data Collection, or EDC. We'll have a brief introduction on EDC and go through the piano app in detail to see it in action. But first, what is Edge? Edge is one of the five types of Enlightenment Foundation Libraries, or EFL, available to Tizen. It is a complex graphic design and layout library. It supports the EDC script language. With this, we can design the GUI without writing a line of C code. It also makes the design scalable and enables animation. Basically, we split the entire application into two parts: the GUI layout and executable logic binaries, resulting to a more expandable code. In case you want a different design, you can simply switch the current EDC file. To explain further, let's see what happens to these two files when running the application. We have here the EDC and C files. EDC file goes through the Edge compiler, resulting to the EDJ file, which is the GUI layout binary. Finally, the C file goes through the C compiler and creates an executable binary that loads the layout. The EDC script file consists of predefined blocks. First is the collections that list the groups that compose the theme. A group corresponds to one layout widget that consists of parts and programs. Images is simply a list of image files to be used. Part is simply the basic design element like text. Image is the default type, and a lot more. The program defines the behavior of each part and serves as a bridge between application and interface. These are the basics. We'll cover more as we go on to the code. Nothing much to prepare beforehand. We'll just need the Tizen IDE. For the coding part, you can get the piano sample app from the SDK itself. Buttons.edc defines the images to be used for the keys, which are actually buttons, depending on the state. Here, we specify the image file, which is to be passed as a parameter, and its compression level. COMP is for lossless compression. We also have scaling. This can either be 0 or 1 to disable or enable scaling of the specific part. Notice that for a single part, we have three descriptions. They differ in the state. It can be clicked, invisible, or default, coupled with an index between 0.0 and 1.0. Normal, here, is part of the image and it specifies the image to be used. Color, RGB and alpha, simply sets the main color to values between 0 and 255. Inherit simply inherits the properties of the specified description name. Any definition on this part will override inherited properties. Piano.edc file is responsible for putting the piano keys in place. They are of type swallow, and positions are relative to one another. First, we have the white keys. Here we have rel 1 to note the top left corner of the image, and rel 2 for the bottom right corner. Relative takes in the X and Y position between 0 and 1. Part index here keeps track of key number. White keys are simpler to place as compared to black keys. Here we have to consider the number of the white key on the left for rel 1 and white key on the right for rel 2. That's about it for EDC files. Now on to the C files. The piano create view function creates the window which consists of a layout with a series of Elm button components that represent real piano notes. For each newly created button, the application registers different callbacks to provide multi-touch and gesture support. To optimize the application performance, each player must be initialized and prepared before playing a sound corresponding to the linked note. Responding to different types of mouse events, the application extracts the target note, changes its style to indicate the pressed and unpressed note view, and plays the associated sound file. Finally, to play sounds, the application checks the current status of the selected note and starts playing the associated sound file. Here are some key points in today's episode. Split the application in two: the executable logic binary and the GUI layout binary. Expand your code without the domino effect on its functionality. The dynamic EDC editor is only available on Linux version of the SDK for now. Code on the right side, real-time view on the left. That's it for Edge Data Collection with a demo of the Piano Sample app. You can check out developer.tizen.org for code snippets and more information. Now for inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Don't forget to give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel. Thanks for watching.